As Amir Amanullah Khan took over as King of Afghanistan in 1919, Gandhiji arrived on the Indian political horizon in 1913. Gandhiji's leadership attracted the best brains far and wide, and among his outstanding colleagues was Abdul Ghaffar Khan from Pashtunistan. Along with his elder brother Dr. Khan Sahib, Badshah Khan rose to emerge as India's legendary figure, which earned him the sobriquet of Frontier Gandhi. Badshah Khan's ideology of non-violence originated from the teachings of the Quran, as he himself put it. Badshah Khan's struggle was twofold, directed not only against the British for the independence of India and Pashtun land, but a passion that made him spend at least 20 years in Pakistani jails. He died in 1988 at the age of 98 and was buried in his beloved Jalalabad in deference to his wishes. Subhash Chandra Bose became a household name and a legend during his lifetime. His quest for freedom took him to Afghanistan disguised as a Pathan on the way to Europe. He got all the sympathy and support from his friends in Afghanistan in this great escape to enlist the support of European powers opposed to British hegemony. Raja Mahendra Pratap wrote his memoirs of Afghanistan titled Afghanistan, the Heart of Haryana. His affection to this land has been epitomized in his introduction to his memoirs. The land-bound island, the valleys full of fruits, mountains rich in mines, it is Afghanistan. Soil raises heavy crops, sparkling rivers flow along, climate is cool and healthy, it is all in Afghanistan. People are bold and sturdy, to play the host ever ready, can rely on them in any case, this is Afghanistan. On the social and cultural planes too, one comes across a similar story. All India Radio had already opened a Pashto unit in 1939, but more concrete steps came only after India got freedom. Vice President Dr. Zakir Hussain laid the foundation stone of Indira Gandhi Hospital for Children in 1966, which now stands as a vibrant institution. The University of Kabul has withstood these onslaughts with equanimity. Its president, Professor Akbar Popal's special interest is of India's scientific and literary achievements. He fondly talks of the advance of information technology while he was in Bangalore and looks forward to closer collaboration between his university and the institutions of higher learning in Bangalore.
I would love to have a relation in contract with some universities in India, especially if it is possible, which I have visited that almost 10 years ago, Agriculture University of Bangalore. Yes. They have not a faculty of agriculture, but the Agricultural University of Bangalore. It's a university with different faculty like forestry, agronomy, plant protections, horticulture, and others.
India's legendary Nobel laureate, Rabindranath Tagore, wrote a powerful story immortalizing the character of Kabuliwala. The story veers round the pangs of separation of the Kabuliwala from his growing daughter and his subsequent return to his much beloved homeland. The film became an instant hit both in India and Afghanistan, where it was translated in both Pashto and Dari. The Kabuliwala proved to be a catalyst, which won popularity for other Hindi films.
Hindi films bhi chalte hai, angrezi films bhi chalte hai, afghani films bhi chalte hai. और ज़्यादा हिंदी फिल्मों चलते हैं उर्दू और फारसी दोनों एक जैसी है और ये जो हमारा लोग है हिंदी बहुत पसंद करते हैं हिंदी फिल्मों में बहुत रश इसलिए है कि इसके गाने भी अच्छे हैं कहानी भी अच्छी है थोड़ा समझ आता है कुछ लोगों को थोड़ा समझ भी नहीं आता है फिर भी हिंदी फिल्मों ये लोग बहुत देख सकते हैं एक्टर्स अक्षय कुमार सुनील शेट्टी ये जो फिल्म है सनी देओल उससे लड़कों के फिल्म बहुत इधर चलते हैं और बाजार बहुत है
Many of the families who had left Afghanistan are now coming back. Afghanistan is their home. They speak Pashto and Dari fluently. The bitter memories of the past have in no way dimmed their love for their homeland.